Don't know if anyone's watching this. I think it's working now. I don't even know if there's any volume coming through. But here we go. This is The Hunter, Call of the Wild. It was released today, a few hours ago. Excuse me while I pop a beer.
Now,
hi, I heard you'd finally arrived. Welcome to Central Europe.
I'll just be quiet while
I'm
she
Connie,
talks.
I'm Connie, the Wildhüter of Hirschfelden, Reserve Warden, that is. I'm here to make sure that your time here will be unforgettable. Hirschfelden is one of the oldest hunting reserves in Europe, and we host a diverse population of the most popular big game for all hunting tastes. It's also the most beautiful place on Earth. No, I'm not biased at all. Go ahead and have a look around. I can't wait for you to experience all the beauty of Hirschfelden's fields and forests. Why don't you see if you can find an animal track nearby?
Right. So I have mucked around on it for a couple of hours already, and that's why I guess it's starting in the night time now. But I've just started a new game. I played for about an hour before this. I don't even know if this is actually broadcasting. I'm just going to quickly check, see if I can see if it's broadcasting or not. Yep, looks good. All right. So I won't talk too much. Just let anybody who happens to be watching make up their own mind of what they think about it. Just going to accept this mission to track down and harvest an animal. These callers are things that you start with. I think the call there that the deer put out was a warning call, so I doubt they'll be too interested in these lures, but who knows. That is the first kill of the game. I might have missed it. But if it is, it was pretty bloody easy.
There should be a track nearby.
I hope she doesn't do that the whole way through the game. Okay, this is a vital hit, so I guess it won't get too far. Can't really see any way to take it.
If you want to get your bearings, there are lookout points spread out all over the reserve.
I don't know how to take a trophy shot like you could in the classic one. Okay, I'll accept this mission as well, because there is a lookout point just to my left. Well, it's actually behind me. What's this? Damn, I just missed that little pop-up. It said something about hunting pressure, which might have been interesting. We'll have to watch the video and see what it said. Just wondering if I can turn the headlamp off, and I can with L. There's a weird thing here, you can't get back to the game. There's a bug. You have to go to the map and then press escape to be able to go back. There we go. No idea if the headlamp spooks animals or dazzles them or even attracts them, I've got no idea. Barging through the bush at the moment because I'm just trying to get to this lookout point. I'm not trying to shoot anything else at the moment. In fact, I can go for a little bit of a run. You can see in the little status bar, the bottom right hand corner, there's the little heartbeat thing there. So apparently if you move around too quick, running around, that goes up. And then if it's still high, when you try and shoot something, it'll make it a lot harder to aim. It's kind of interesting. Get in here. Oh, jump over the fence. You can jump in this one. Makes a lot of noise. Dark, obviously. Wonder how far that headlamp will light up.
Quite a view, isn't it? From here, you can see a lot of great hunting opportunities in the nearby area. Rattenfeld is a favorite region for a lot of hunters. The fallow deer is such a classic animal to hunt. But we also get a lot of history buffs here. To the south lies the Hirschdorf Hügelgrab, a grave mound dating back to the Bronze Age. Be sure to stop by one of the outposts. They're essentially base camps.
All right, so that's the next thing we'll do. Move around, okay. So here we are. We'll just follow this path directly up north to the base camp here. Check out what this is. And I believe once I'm there, I'm going to be able to rest until it's morning. So if anyone is watching, you'll be able to see a little bit better. Once again, I'm not going to worry too much about hunting just yet. I mean, if I hear or see something on the way, of course, I'll check it out. I just want to get to that cabin and rest for a couple of hours. There's something right in front of us. Graphics are really great, aren't they? It really looks cool. That to me looks a lot like real life if you're ever walking around the nature with a headlamp on. And I love the distortion on the binoculars too, around the edges. You can see the flowers closest to me are really out of focus, and that it's just looks great. Like I said before, I don't know what effect the lamp is going to have if this animal comes towards me, but I don't know. There's only one way to find out, I guess. Well, apparently there's something there. Might just be able to see the outline there. Looks like there's a few of them. I don't know how well that's coming up on YouTube, but I can just make out the faint outlines of some animals. To see anything at all, obviously, so the sooner I get to that cabin, the better. I guess this light is going to scare them all, but it doesn't matter. Quite a few bandies there. I'm pretty sure that on the right hand side there is a male. I think this one is a male. It's got a molted skin on it. Oh, I didn't drop it. Let's just see what this is on the way. Okay, I think I don't know what this is. It's some ancient pile of stones or something. But I think the codex that you might have seen mentioned just then is like an encyclopedia of terms in the game that you can read about stuff there. Non-vital hit. These tracks are pretty easy to see in the night, at least. The blue ones there are the ones of the animal that I'm currently tracking, and the white ones are the other animals. You see the tracks only show up within the spotlight, which is kind of cool. How would you see them otherwise? I was just about to say, I hope we're not going to have to chase this through the forest at night, but there we go. That's got the special fur type, piebald fur type. And the shot was not a good one. Anyway, at least we saw something. Have a look where I am. I've got to go northeast from here. Realized I hadn't even accepted that mission yet, but I just did it then.
cozy, right? Outposts are great for stocking up or just taking a break.
Waiting for that music to stop. It's really, really loud in my headphones. Just leaving the outpost.
Gerlinda is lovely, but here's a friendly tip. Don't ask her about fallow deer unless you mean it. She will not stop. It's beyond obsession at this point. On the other hand, there's no one better for hunting tips when it comes to fallows. Oh, and her venison stew is out of this world. Makes me hungry just thinking about it.
Right, okay. So that was a lot of noise coming through my headphones at once, the music and her talking. But so you press P to get your camera out. It's got a pretty good zoom lens by the look of it. Okay. Now, I did do the, because I'm a member of the Hunter Classic, there was some deal where you got a 270 Magnum rifle. Can't see it there. I suppose your rifle score's got to go up high enough to get it or something, I don't know. But it ain't there. This is the one I've got. You have to buy ammo in this game as well. You can run out. I wish they had the same sort of clothing system that they did in Classic, but it doesn't look like it. And it actually says in this description somewhere, there. It doesn't matter what you wear, that doesn't make any difference to how the animals detect you. Kind of preferred the Classic's way of doing it, to be honest. So I guess that's how you equip things. Sounds sounds like an aeroplane somewhere. Maybe it's a power generator for the cabin or something. Alright, so may as well accept this mission. I guess this is the main outpost, so I'll see if I can find a fellow deer to photograph. We take a photo of it and then shoot it, but it's just kind of the kind of asshole I am. Still got that headlamp on. There we go. Okay. And now what's what? This map, I don't know if they're fields or not. Oh, these will be fields here. So I will head over towards these fields. Let's see if I can maybe sit up here somewhere and glass around here a little bit. Just quickly show you something cool you can do with this game that I discovered when I was stuffing around before. You go to display game. Ah, yeah, here we go. So you can change the field of view to how you like to see things. I'm not sure what it was on originally, but I made it a bit bigger. I turned it to about 80, just because I've got a pretty big monitor here. And I forget what it starts on, maybe 70 or 60 or something. Anyway, so once again, it says down here, press escape to close, but it doesn't work. You have to go to the map and then press escape. I'm sure they'll have that fixed up pretty quick. Oh. One nice thing about this game is you don't need the hunter mode out all the time to identify tracks and stuff, which is a big improvement, I reckon. I think they should just do away with that hunter mode altogether and just display the stuff on the screen in an overlay, but it's sort of halfway there, so pretty good. see in the bottom right-hand corner, the little bars there that go up to the red bars. That's how much noise I'm making. I'm making none. And a little bit. I don't know what the dot in between the heart and the noise symbol is, but I guess I'll find out. Someone's getting their firewood, I guess. Render distance is a lot better in this game. I don't know exactly what it is, but from some of the beta testing that I saw, it's so far that you wouldn't be taking shots at that distance anyway, so. I think there's going to be fields on the other side of this hill, so I just want to approach the area a little bit carefully. If I'm not lost. A bit of a graphics glitch there. Not really the fields I was hoping for. In the right place. Nope. This is the one I wanted to get to. Oh, look at that, a squirrel. Looked like a bloody big squirrel, too. When I was mucking around and played the game before, I shot a rabbit. And you didn't have any option of harvesting it or anything. I don't know why not. Maybe it's because I used the wrong type of gun or something, or maybe it's something that has to be unlocked. But I liked rabbit hunting in the first one, and the rabbits seem to behave a lot more realistically in this one, so it'd be good if they did have the rabbit hunting in it. When I was looking at the guns in the store, it didn't say what animals you could use them for, so I don't know if that was the problem or not. I'm just looking for the sound waves from that dog barking. I guess it must be a fox or something. they've got the auto walk feature like in the original one, but they don't have the thing where you could lock the direction you're walking and kind of look around as you're walking in a straight line, which is kind of annoying because I used that a lot in the classic. I don't know if anyone's watching this. I might just have a look at the YouTube channel and see if I can tell. Oh, one person is watching, so if you can hear me, g'day. Thanks for watching. Can you see the texture on the binocular lens? It's pretty mad. I'm not really making these videos to be a famous YouTube person or anything like that. It just kind of makes it a bit more fun for me, so it doesn't really worry me if one person is watching or no people are watching. Thanks, mate, anyway, whoever you are. as well see if I can find this road here. I'm not having much luck with anything else. The animals seem a lot harder to find in this game than what it looked like in the beta. So I don't know if they adjusted that or if they just had the beta chock full of animals for testing purposes or whatever, or maybe I'm just a real shit player. Probably all of the above, I would guess. This bloody road here. I'm just going to stick to the original plan. Get up here and have a look down on these fields. Because finding the animals in the thick forest is a bit of a nightmare. It's just a couple of bunny rabbits, I think, bouncing off through the bush in front of me. I do hope this is not too boring for my one viewer. you're wondering what I'm running this on, it's a i7 processor and a GTX 980 video card. And it's got 64 gig of RAM. So that's a pretty high-end system, really. It's a couple of years old now, but when I built it, I kind of just maxed it out. And I'm running it with everything on ultra settings, so the graphics settings are as high as they can go. And you can see the render distance there is pretty good, although there's no animal to test it with. Nice to spot something off in the distance there just to see how far you can see. There we go. Picked up some fallow deer glassing. Oh, what's that? Is that the render distance making it disappear, or did it just walk behind a hill? So I'm just going to head over and see if I can get a photograph of one of these fallow deer to complete the mission. Didn't look like there was any bucks in that group, unfortunately. Obviously, it's not good having a gale at my back, but what can you do? I'll try and kind of edge around a bit this way and hopefully make it a little bit more difficult for them to smell me, if they haven't already. I don't know, is this where I saw them, or was it the next ridge over there? Doesn't seem to be any tracks around. probably been a little more careful, I guess. That was a warning call from a roe deer, but where's the roe deer? There you go. I believe in this game the vegetation does actually camouflage you, which it didn't do in the classic. You could only hide behind rocks and trees and things. One roe deer down. Obviously I'm trying to photograph fallow deer, but anyway, I'm just kind of playing, experimenting with the game as I go. Wonder if you can take a trophy shot. doesn't seem to be any sort of trophy shot option. There you go. Well, I'm going to have to call it a night. My girlfriend's waiting for me. So I don't know how many people will end up watching this, maybe more than one. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you got something out of it. And if you could hear me, leave a comment and let me know you could hear me. See you later.